my goodness, what is this, Marksman? This isn't Call of Duty. This isn't Search and Destroy. This is... Yeah, well, fuck you guys. This is Battlefield 4. We are playing Dawnbreaker Domination, which is essentially the same thing as Domination in Call of Duty. You control the points on the map. You gotta go capture them. You kill people on the way and gotta defend them if you're gonna be campy and sit back and wait and watch. I don't do that so much. I'm more of the objective player. I'll capture a place and be like, all right, you guys can have this back. I'm going for one of your other ones now. We'll just switch off points, get some more points this way. We'll level up quicker, shake hands, let's go. Anyways, this is the M416 Assault Rifle. I'm using the defensive little thingy down in the bottom left. I'm not sure what that is really called. I just know it's defensive-ish. Using a red dot sight, using the shotgun secondary thing, the M62 Mass, whatever. I don't know how it's pronounced or anything like that. I use it once in a while. I do like using it. It's kind of fun, although its hit detection is sketchy and pisses me off at times. So, look at that. Get knifed. Sit down. I'm scared to knife people because in the beta, every time you try to knife someone, they would just counter it and knife you back. And it was like, fuck! Fuck! This is bullshit! Not so much in this. They haven't countered it. And I haven't countered anyone that's knifed me either. I don't know if it's just that I've been lucky or what. Anywho's, this is Battlefield 4. Like I said, I'm not a big Battlefield player yet, although I do have fun playing it. My KD is like a 2-something in it. My skill rating is 410 currently. I'm trying to get to the 500s. I'm level 7, woohoo, go me. This is my level 7 game. I almost get to level 8. And this is a backpacking game. This game I absolutely destroy. This is what I did like every single game during the beta. It's a 38 kill game. We win by about 100 tickets. If you don't know what tickets are, it's like... You start with 300 score. And your ticket count goes down every time someone respawns on your team. If they die and they respawn, it also goes down by how many captures you have. So if you have 2 flags, it goes down by 2 every like 5 seconds or 10 seconds or something like that. So basically, having domination points bleeds tickets on them. That makes them bleed tickets slowly or fast, depending on how many you have. And getting kills and doing well in the game is another good way to make them lose tickets in a decent manner. Although, I can say you can hold one flag and win, that's very, very unlikely, unless your team is just monstrous at getting kills. Most of the time, you want to have 2 for a majority of the game, while being able to effectively kill the enemy team. Now, I'm going to be posting Battlefield here and there, along with my Call of Duty, of course, and Minecraft, and when Titanfall comes out, we're going to no-life that, because, in all honesty, if a game has a gun in it, and it's an FPS type of game, more likely than not, I can do well at it and make it good. Titanfall, I'm really looking forward to. That's what Battlefield spawn right there. That's bullshit. Man, it looks like Call of Duty spawns almost. Right in front of me. Poof, dead. Also, never spawn on your teammates in this. I found that out. So we're looking forward to Titanfall. I understand there are some weird things in the game that people aren't going to be used to. I'm technically kind of used to bots being in the game because that was similar in Gears of War, where if you didn't have a teammate, it would fill in with a bot. So I'm not too skeptical about it being bad because Gears of War, even though it had bots sometimes, was a fantastic game. It was a lot of fun to play. And although it didn't last, in Gears of War 3 right there is a great example of why you don't spawn on your teammates. Although Gears of War 3 did not last in terms of popularity, I think it easily could have. It was, in my opinion, a really fun game to play. A lot of people that I knew from Call of Duty and from the Gears community loved playing it. I'm not so sure on like the new ones, the Judgments and things like that, but GoW 3 was a lot of fun, in my opinion. It was a lot of fun, and I really did enjoy it, so I think Titanfall can be equally as fun or more fun, depending on the game. My only complaint about Gears of War is that it was a little clunky feeling moving around. And it's similar to Battlefield. I'd say Battlefield's a bit smoother, but, you know, it was like a 30 FPS game, and the controls were a little weird, I would say. But still, a lot of fun. A lot of fun. I loved it. So, I still do. I just don't play it, because I spend most of my time on this doing videos or streaming. Which, by the way, stream shout-out, thank you guys for showing up yesterday. We did an 8-hour stream on Modern Warfare 2. I played with a lot of you. Met a lot of new people as well that came to the stream, so that was awesome. I'll be streaming MW2 again today in a little bit after this video goes up for like, you know, 3 or 4 hours. Not an 8-hour stream again, but like I wanted to say, thank you guys. Thank you. I really do appreciate that you showed up if you did, and I hope you had some fun in it. I try to make it enjoyable, so that was overall really good to me. So, oh, here's the shotgun. What is it called? Never mind. I got absolutely dicked on. Oh my god. just raped me. I don't know if they made snipers better since the beta or what, but I got quickscoped, I think, 2 times during this game. The guy was trying to get into phase Battlefield Edition. Like, fucked me so hard. That's not cool. Anyways, this map is Dawnbreaker. What I've noticed about this map is it's very annoying when people sit on the outskirts and use, like, LMGs or snipers, although I have a teammate doing that this game. He's not very useful. I don't know if he... Maybe, I don't know. Maybe he was. He just didn't feel very useful because I kept running around, like, shooting everyone. He's not very useful on the A bomb site, granted. He probably gives a lot of cover on the C and B bomb sites. Here, I was getting shot in the back, but I was like, you know, I'm just going to shoot the guys in front. I don't have enough time to turn around. I don't play on high sensitivity in this. It's bad, in my opinion, so... But Dawnbreaker, a lot of people sit on the outside with LMGs or snipers. Like, it's distracting because, you know, they have to worry about that guy all the time shooting them. It's pretty annoying because I had to do that against someone. They kept killing me, and I can't really reach them with the gun I'm using. Like, the rifles are okay, but they're not like snipers, okay? If I wanted to put on a sniper and try to hit them, I probably could have, but I didn't want to spend my time switching to a recon class to take out one dude. Because I find that I'm really important when it comes to taking flags and moving up and, like, pushing. My teammates just don't like to do that a whole lot. I get a lot of people that spawn on me because I'm good at it and doing and keeping my movement, you know, like, fluid, pushing toward an objective. But, like I said, it's an annoying thing that I found in this map. I'm hoping that I don't get it too often, although I understand why people do it. It raises their KD. I don't think KD is all god in this. It is important. Like I said, when you die, you lose a ticket, but it is not all godlike. It's not like Search and Destroy where KD is really important. You need to have a positive KD, at least someone on your team or two or half your team does. I think it's important that, you know, you can have probably two or three people going positive out of your 8-man team in this or whatever it is, your 10-man, 12-man team. I don't know. It's something that, like, almost 10 people. And you can still win a game as long as that the rest of the whole team is playing the objective in some manner by running around and capturing flags. So... KD is important, but I don't think it's as important in Search and Destroy, or as important as in Search and Destroy, or Defuse in the game mode in this game, which is similar to Search. One life, kind of arm the bomb, defuse the bomb. I'll try to play more Defuse for you, by the way. Don't plan on it yet. I've been playing Domination just because this is what I kind of understand. I wanted to learn the maps better, and although Defuse is good, and Search and Destroy is good for learning maps, it doesn't really... show an entire map always, because there's no point to ever go on the outskirts, the far, far, far outskirts of a map when you don't have to in Search. So right here you can see a nice little triple kill or quad shotgun, M22 dart, M22-6 dart, double kill, triple kill, switch back to the M416, find him in the street, get the fourth going down. That was a good little streak there, really nice. But as I was saying, a lot of people like to sit on the outside of the map with the snipers or LMGs, which I don't find very useful. Most of the time, though, I see a lot of people run up through the middle on this map to get... I mean, the middle is obviously probably the quickest way from A to C, but I really don't see a lot of people run on the... well, I guess, what is that? There's the southeast corner. If you look at the little bottom map on the bottom left side, you can see south and east, where I picked up that four-man. I don't see people run along that outside very often, and I think that's probably one of the most... underrated spots, because I love taking that outside way to get into A. No one ever looks there, no one ever goes there, no one ever thinks about it. I did right off the bat because that's where I love to go, but most people don't. Right here, I got the dick. I fucking hate shotguns, dude. Oh, that is enraging. I hate dying to that shit. I hit the corner, boom, dead. Boom, dead. Boom, dead. Oh, dude, drives me crazy. And I know how good they are because I use the shotgun attachment on the rifle, M26 dart. I'm not sure what other attachments there are that might be worth using on that. I mean, there's the noob tube, but I don't really like the noob tube in this game. It's very weak. It can give you suppressed fire, which is really nice, but the shotgun, since I'm usually like in people's faces. Like, I don't like to waste my time and jerk off in the corners and shit and try to shoot noob tubes at people. I'm usually in their face, and when I run out of ammo... and I don't want to switch to a pistol, and I think a shotgun's better close range, I use the shotgun. So, I'll usually go through the M14 ammo, then I switch to the shotgun, and if I still have people, then I'll Y switch to my pistol, and I'll shoot the pistol ammo off as well. I'll get everything off, all my ammo out, I won't have to reload at any point during that, which is great, because that's the most important part. You don't want to spend time reloading mid-gunfight, alright, because you will die, and it's not cool. Even though the M416 whatever has a fast reload time compared to most rifles, I think it's really quick. I would much prefer to just swap weapons and kill them with something else. Because the pistols are strong, the shotgun is certainly strong, and it's really, really important, I think, that you get used to cycling through that. instead of just dying, which most people do. But, like I said, I hate the shotguns. I don't like getting shotgunned. It bugs the hell out of me. It seems to happen all the time, too. I seem to get shotgunned, like, 24-7, and it's so disappointing. But I gotta figure out either... I gotta either... Two options. One, avoid the shotguns, or two, get better with my own and outgun them. So I have those two options to take, and I gotta see if I can do that. Could not hit that guy to save my life. I suck. Couldn't do it. Couldn't do it. But I also wanted to know... There's two reasons I want to know this. One, do you guys want to see full videos like this, or do you want me to cut it up into the most action-packed parts and then show you the end of the game, like the result? Or if you'd like to see the full video, and I can post that as well. One, the first reason, obviously it's a long video, 14 minutes. I don't want you guys to have to watch a 14-minute video if you're not really interested in all of it. Also, because it is not easy to talk for 14 minutes. If you've ever done commentaries, you know it's difficult. If you've done 6 or 7 minute commentaries and you've struggled, try doing 2 times that. 14 minutes is a long time, by any means, okay? Ask any YouTube commentator. If they're going to do a 14 minute video, they better have a lot on their mind and they better be passionate about it, because it is not easy to do a 14 minute video. It's like giving a speech on something that you're just thinking about on the top of your head constantly and not taking a break the entire time. It's just, it's not something that you're used to. And at the same time, it's not something that you can really get good at unless you're going to do a lot of 14-minute videos. And most people don't do those, because if you're going to do something of that length, usually it's like a live video where you don't have to worry about commentating on something. Right here, picking up some kills with the M26 again. Like, this gun right here, what is this? The sniper that's a one-shot. Holy God, does this thing suck close range. That thing is fantastic long range. It is garbage close range. I could not hit anything. Every time I pick it up, I try to get to the outside and do what my teammates were doing and give cover. Only for as much ammo as I have in the gun, then I get back in close with my M416. But, dude, do not use that thing to quickscope with. It is garbage. A real sniper right here. Fucking teammate! Ugh! You fucking enraging, dude. Oh. If I recorded live videos, you would just hear me, like, spawn in, like, alright, where are they at? Where are they at? I would die, and I'd be like, fuck! I'm not even kidding. That is exactly what it's like. I'm sorry. You can turn your headset down a little bit. You might want to. It's literally enraging when I die because of my teammate like that. I'm so pissed. Yesterday, after streaming for a while and yelling, I mean, I wasn't really yelling because I was angry, more or less because it was funny. But, oh, Claymore, damn it. I should have saw that. After playing yesterday and yelling a little bit during stream, and then, what the fuck is he doing out there? The dude just running around in circles, jerking off. What the fuck? Playing Battlefield after, my voice was shot. Like, I could not talk at all. I'd yelled so much during the day. I was like, damn. But, yeah. I mean, if I recorded live, you guys would probably laugh, because I get so pissed at this game. And I shouldn't. It's, like, stuff that's way out of my control. I'm just like, why are they there? I don't know. Why are they going to be there? I shouldn't spawn on my teammate. My teammate's a fucking idiot. Shouldn't have done that. It's my fault the whole time. But I just get so annoyed because my teammate, they do stupid shit, man. They do stupid shit and it drives me crazy. It's like, guys, I played this for like 4 hours and I'm doing shit that's smarter than you. You're like, you have like 40 hours played on this game. What are you doing? But yeah, I might do a live video or something, but it might be a little sketchy. 38 and 12 though. I hope you guys have enjoyed the Battlefield video for today. Search and Destroy is back tomorrow. We'll do an MW2 Search and Destroy stream in a little bit as well. Comment, rate, and subscribe if you'd like. If not, no worries. I will still love you, and as always, make sure to keep on gaming.